Hello kids, for today's objectives, we are going to state and illustrate the different properties of operations on integers, and we're going to rewrite the given expressions according to the given property. Let's start with the first property, and this is closure property. So what is closure property? So when the two integers a and b that are added and multiplied, it will always remain as integers. So for example, a plus b, so a and b are both integer, so the resulting answer is also integer. A times b are also integer, so equals integer. So that's the concept, the idea of the closure property. Let's have the example. 3 plus 5 equals 8. 3 is an integer. 5 is also an integer. So the answer is should be integer, right? Okay. So like, for example, 3 times 5, 3 is an integer. 5 is also an integer. So the resulting answer or the sum is integer. So this is now the idea. So when the two integers are added or multiplied, the result will always be an integer. How about subtraction? Is the set of integers closed under subtraction? The answer is yes. So we can apply closure property to subtraction. Okay, for example, 3 minus 5. So they are all integers, so the result is also integer. 5 minus 3. So 5 is an integer. 3 is also an integer. So the resulting answer is also an integer. So this is the closure property. The next property, we have the commutative property. And there are two operations that we can apply, the addition and multiplication. Okay, so if you add the two real numbers or the integers in any order, the sum will always be the same or equal. So what's the pattern here? A plus B equals B plus A. So what does it mean? So changing the order of the two integers will not affect the answer. It will not change the answer. So, yung A ang nauna, ang B ang nasa huli. Kapag baliktarin mo, yung B ang nauna at ang A ang nasa huli, the same result that we get. Okay, so like for example, we have 1 plus 2 equals, if we try to change their position, 2 plus 1. So, if you try to get your answer, 1 plus 2 is 3 and 2 plus 1 is still 3. So, they are equal. So see, that is now the idea of commutative property. That changing their order, their position, will not affect their result, the answer. Okay? So just like this one, 15 plus 20. Okay? So 15 yung nauna, yung nasa huli, yung 20. Kapag baliktarin natin, 20 yung nauna at 15 yung nasa huli. Let's check if they get the same result. Yes. See? Still the same answer. Kahit you change their order, still we get the same result. Ito ang idea or concept ng commutative property under addition. Okay? So we have commutative property of addition. And for multiplication, we also have this concept. So there's the pattern A times B equals B times A. So the same. If you multiply two real numbers or the integers in any order, the product will always be the same or equal. So the same idea in commutative property of addition, but this time it's multiplication. So for example, 7 times 2. Then, we change the order 2 times 7. So, if you try to get their product, You multiply them, 7 times 2, the answer is 14. And 2 times 7 is also 14. So, it means they are equal. So, it will not change or it will not affect the result whether you change their order. Okay, the same idea with addition and multiplication. So, 9 times 10, if you change their order, 10 times 9, still they get the same result, 90. So, they are equal. Okay, so this is now the idea of commutative property, but only in addition and multiplication. We cannot apply this in subtraction and division because if you change their order, their result or their answer will change. Next property, we have associative property, and there are two operations that we can apply, the addition and multiplication. So let's start with addition. If you are adding three real numbers or integers, the sum is always the same regardless of their grouping. So now we are talking about grouping. So let's first study the pattern of this property. We have the quantity of A plus B plus C equals A plus the quantity B plus C. So what does it mean? So changing the groups or the grouping will not affect or change the answer. So the same idea with the commutative property, but the commutative property talks about changing the order will not affect the answer, but this time changing the groupings. So we are talking about group. So changing the groupings or the group will not affect the result. So as you can see here, A plus B are in one group. Yung C ay nasa labas. Kapag we change the groupings, si A na naman nasa labas, si B at si C ang nasa loob. So regardless of their groupings, you change the group, still we get the same answer. Okay? So walang pagkakaiba yung result or yung sagot nila. Still the same. So let's have another example. The quantity 1 plus 2 plus 3 equals 1 plus the quantity 2 plus 3. As you can see, si 1 at si 2 ay nasa loob ng grupo. Si 3 nasa labas. Kapag pinag-iba natin yung groupings or we change the group, si 1 ay nasa labas, si 2 at si 3 ay nasa loob ng group. So let's check if still we get the same result. Okay, so see, first we add 2 plus 1 plus 2, 3 plus 3. So here also 1 plus, so we start adding 2 plus 3, that's 5. So 3 plus 3, 6, then 1 plus 5, 6. See, so still we get the same result. Okay, so let's have more examples. The quantity 4 plus 5 plus 6 equals 4, nasa labas na naman, plus the quantity 5 plus 6. So first we add 4 plus 5, so we get 9, then plus 6, oh that's it, equals, so si 4, i-add muna natin si 5 o si 6, 11, so 4 plus 11. Okay, so 9 plus 6, we get 15, and 4 plus 11, we also get 15. So they are equal. So see, changing the groupings will not affect their result. So for multiplication, the same idea in addition. If you are multiplying three real numbers or the integers, the product is always the same regardless of their groupings. Which means changing the groupings or the group will not affect the result. It will not change the answer. So here's now the pattern, the quantity A times B times C equals A times the quantity B times C. So tingnan niyo yung grouping sila na iba. Okay? So let's have more example. The quantity 1 times 2 times 3 equals 1 times the quantity 2 times 3. Again, let's start from the inside. 1 times 2, 2. Then here 2 times 3 is 6, then times 1, then 2 times 3 we have 6, then 1 times 6 we have 6. So again, we get the same result. Again, regardless of the groupings, still we get the same result. So another example, we have the quantity 4 times 5 times 6 equals 4 times the quantity 5 times 6. Again, let's start with 4 times 5, 20 times 6, then 4 times 5 times 6, 30, right? Okay, so 20 times 6, 120, 4 times 30, 120, see? Still the same result. So here's now the concept or the idea of associative property. Next property, we have identity property. So there are again two operations that we can apply. So we have the addition and multiplication. So let's start with addition. So if you add a real number or integer to zero, the sum will always be the original number itself. So what does it mean? So we have this pattern, A plus zero equals, so when you add A to zero, the result will always be the same number. So the same or the original number will always remain. So another example, 1 plus 0. So when you add 1 to 0, the result will always be the same number. Negative 5 plus 0. So the answer is negative 5. 1/5 plus 0, still 1/5. So anong ibig sabihin nito? So again, anong number na i-add natin sa any integer, so any number, to remain the original number itself. Okay? At walang iba kundi si zero lang. So zero is the additive identity. Kasi when you add zero to any integers, the sum is the same number. Okay? So yung identity niya will remain dahil ni zero. So against zero ang yung additive identity. Okay? Now for multiplication, if you multiply a real number or integer to 1, the product will be the original number itself. Again, so sa addition, ang i-add mo ay 0 para ma-maintain yung original identity. Sa multiplication, ang i-multiply mo ay 1. So that the original number itself will remain. So that's the idea. Kaya si 1 ay tinatawag na multiplicative identity. Sa addition, si 0 ay additive identity. Sa multiplication, si 1 ang multiplicative identity. So, okay, for example, with this pattern, A times 1 equals A. So when you multiply A to 1, A will always remain, right? So another example, 2 times 1. So when you multiply 2 to 1, the product will be 2. So, negative 5 times 1, again, it will remain negative 5. 1/5 times 1, still 1/5. See? So this is now the concept of an identity property of multiplication. So any integers or any numbers multiplied by 1, still the same number, the same identity. So it will not change because of 1. Okay, so 1 again is called the multiplicative identity. Dahil sa kanya, the number itself will remain. So it will not change. Again, for the addition, 0 is the additive identity. So when you add 0 to any number, it will always remain the same number. Let's proceed to the next property, and that is inverse property. There are two operations that we can apply, the addition and multiplication. For addition, the sum must be 0. For multiplication, the product must be 1. Okay, so what does it mean? So let's start with the first operation, the addition. So if you add a real number or any integer and its opposite, you will always get zero. So when you add any number and its opposite, so like for example, A plus, what is the opposite of positive A? It's negative A. So when you add any number and its opposite, the resulting sum is zero. So for example, 1 plus, what's the opposite of positive 1? Negative 1 equals 0. See? So when you add the number and its opposite, the resulting sum is always 0. So we have negative 5 plus, the opposite is positive 5, of course. So when you add them, then the result is 0. So 1/5 plus the opposite of 1/5 is negative 1/5 equals 0. So the key word here is opposite. That's for the addition. For the multiplication, the key word there is the reciprocal. So when you say inverse, that is the opposite. Okay, so for addition, the sum will always be 0 when you add the number and its opposite. Okay, so the opposite will be the sign. So if it's positive, then the opposite is negative. Now for multiplication, the inverse is not the opposite but the reciprocal. That's the keyword. Okay, so what does it mean? If you multiply a real number or integer and it's reciprocal, the product will always be 1. For example, A. So what is the reciprocal of A? The answer is 1 over A. Why? Where do we get 1? Because all real number or integers have the denominator of 1. So when you multiply A and its reciprocal, the product will always be 1. See? So that's it. For example, 7. The reciprocal is 1 over 7. Okay, so when you multiply, we get the result of 1. Okay, again, all integers have the denominator of 1. But we don't need to write them. But when we get the reciprocal, then we can write 1 as the numerator, 7 as the denominator. Okay, so that's how to get the reciprocal. So when you multiply 7 times 1, 7 divided by 7, then the result is 1. Okay? So let's have more example too. 5 times the reciprocal, it's 5 over 2. So 5 halves. So when you multiply them, 2 times 5 is 10. 5 times 2, also 10. 10 divided by 10, the product will always be 1. Again, for addition, when you add the number and its opposite, the resulting sum is always 0. For multiplication, when you multiply any number to the reciprocal or its reciprocal, the product will always be 1. Next property, we have distributive property. So from the word distribute. Okay, so the operation of multiplication distributes over addition or subtraction operation. So we can apply addition or subtraction. Okay, so here's now the pattern, the concept. A times the quantity B plus C, and A times the quantity B minus C. So when you say distributive property, so we will distribute. So that A, that number or any number, so it distribute natin isa-isa. So A distribute to B, so it will become A times B. And then we will distribute again A to C. Since addition operation ang nasa gitna ng B at C, so plus or addition ang ilagay sa gitna rin. Okay? So we will distribute A to C. So it will become plus
A times C. Okay? So, plus, ang ilagay sa gitna kasi plus ang nandoon sa quantity B plus C. Okay? So, ito yung pattern. So, dinidistribute natin si A to B and C. Okay? Okay, so next we have A times the quantity B minus C. So, the same pattern, distributive property ang ginagamit natin. So, we will distribute A to B and A to C. So, magiging A times B and then distribute A to C. So, magiging minus A times C. Bakit minus or subtraction? Because subtraction ang nasa loob ng quantity B minus C. Okay, so ito yung pattern ng distributive property under subtraction. So let's have an example here. So 2 times the quantity 3 plus 4. So distribute 2 to 3, 2 times 3. Then since it's addition nasa loob, so plus ang ilagay sa gitna. So then next, 2 times 4. I-distribute ito si 4. So magiging 2 times 4. Okay? Let's try to solve both side, the left side and the right side. So let's start with the left side. So of course, remember the PEMDAS rule. So you'll start from the group. So 3 plus 4 is 7, then times 2. Then the other side, applying the distributive property. So we will multiply 2 times 3 and 2 times 4. It will become 6 plus 8. So 2 times 7 is 14. And then 6 plus 8, it's 14. See? You can see they are still equal. So applying the distributive property, that's the right side, and applying the PEMDAS rule, still we get the same result. Okay, so let's have another example. 7 times the quantity, 6 minus 5. So this time the operation inside the quantity 6 and 5 is minus. So we will distribute 7 to 6. It will become 7 times 6. Then minus ang nasa gitna. Then distribute 7 to 5. So 7 times 5. Okay? Then let's solve using the PEMDAS rule. So 7 in times 1. 1, 6 minus 5, that's 1. And then sa right side, so we will multiply 7 and 6, 42. Then 5, 7, it's 35. So 7 times 1, it's 7. Then 42 minus 35, it's also 7. Still, they are equal. So applying the distributive property, still we get the same result. And also the PEMDAS rule, still we get the correct answer. Okay, so this time we will have the last property, and that is zero property of multiplication. What does it mean? The product of any number and zero is always zero. So in each of this equation below, zero is one of the factors. So anong ibig sabihin ng zero property? So when you multiply zero to any number, the result will always be zero. Like for example, 5 times 0 equals 0. So nakikita niyo iba't ibang symbol ang ginagamit ng multiplication, but they're all the same multiplication. Okay, so again, sa idea or the concept of zero property, when you multiply zero to any number, the result will always be zero, or the product is zero. Okay, so this is now the zero property of multiplication. Let's practice this time. So identify the property that justify each statement. Number one, 15 plus negative 15, that's the opposite, equals zero. Remember, when you the number at its opposite, it is additive inverse property. Okay, number two, 25 times 1 equals 25. Again, when you multiply the number and its multiplicative identity. So, what does it mean? So, to remain its identity, we will multiply 1. So, anong property ito? Multiplicative identity property. So number 3, 5 plus 4 equals 9. So when two integers are added, so the resulting sum is always an integer. So what is that? Closure property under addition. Okay, number 4, ito. So, 4 times 5, that is the quantity. Times 6 equals 6 times the quantity, 4 times 5. You have to be careful with this because it's like confusing. So, the property that we apply is commutative property of multiplication. Bakit commutative property ang ginagamit? Kasi hindi ito associative property. So, as you can see, hindi sila nag-iiba ng grupo. So, the same group, okay? I mean, 4 and 5 is still in one quantity, one group yan. So, when they change their order, so we just exchange 6 and the quantity 4 and 5. Ang naiba ay ang yung order, hindi yung grupo. Kaya, commutative property yan. Okay? So, number 5 ito. Quantity 2 plus 3 plus 4 equals 2 plus the quantity 3 plus 4. Okay, you can now check here the group. This time, we are now changing the group. So, ang 4 yung nasa labas, yung sa right side, ang 2 na naman nasa labas. So, anong property ito? Associative property of addition. Kasi merong na iba yung grupo. Okay, number 6. Negative 2 fifth times the reciprocal equals 1. So, it is multiplicative inverse property. So, when you multiply any number and it's reciprocal. So, as you can see, yung 2 fifth, binaliktad siya, nagiging 5 over 2. Now, let's rewrite the given expression using the indicated property. Number 1, 15 plus 13 equals. So, we are asked to apply the commutative property. So, again, when you say commutative property, baliktad yung order. So, we change the order. It will become 13 plus 15. So, number 2, 5 times the quantity 3 plus 2. And we are asked this time to apply the distributive property. So, ano mangyari? So, we will distribute 5 to 3. It will become 5 times 3 plus 5 times 2. Number 3, 5 times blank equals, we are asked this time to apply identity property of multiplication. Again, when you say identity property, so we will multiply 1 to remain the identity na 5. So, magiging 5 times 1 equals 5. So, that's the identity property. So, we use 1, we multiply 5 by 1 to remain its identity. Number 4, quantity 5 plus 2 plus 3. And now, we are applying the associative property of addition. So, again, so we will be changing the group. So, nasa labas si 3, this time we will make 5 na nasa labas si 2 at si 3 ang nasa loob. So, ito yung associative property of addition. Okay, next, negative 4 times blank. So, we are asked to get the 0 property. Again, when you say 0 property, any number multiplied by 0 is always 0. So, that